aired this morning, Seven Group Holdings chairman Kerry Stokes has announced he's stepping down.
Yes, big news in the business world. Kerry Stokes is stepping down as chairman of Seven Group Holdings. Seven Group Holdings is a very large conglomerate company that has brands including WesTrac, a big stake in Boral, also Coates Hire and Seven West Media plus Beach Energy. So Kerry Stokes has announced he's going to step down from his role as chairman at the company's upcoming annual general meeting in November. He has been chair of Seven Group since 2010 and will remain as chairman of Seven West Media. Mr Stokes is going to continue to work in an advisory capacity with Seven Group for at least the next 3 years. This is a quote from Kerry Stokes. "I'm very proud of Seven Group Holdings and its track record, and I'm confident that I leave Seven Group Holdings in the best possible hands under the stewardship of Terry and the board and the leadership of Ryan. I remain very committed to Seven Group Holdings and I will remain involved in the business in an advisory capacity." So Terry Davis, who's been on the board since 2010, will take over as chairman of Seven Group from the annual general meeting in November. Okay. But just to quickly look at Seven Group's profit results, because they also came out today, it was a pretty good year for Seven Group. Its revenue was up 6% to almost $5 billion. Underlying profit was about $500 million. And WesTrac, that's its mining business that sells Caterpillar bulldozers, did very well, EBIT up 8%. And dividend of 23 cents per share. And later today, Laura, Sky News business editor Ross Greenwood is going to be talking to Ryan Stokes, who's the chief executive of Seven Group and also Kerry Stokes' son. So they'll be chatting a bit later today on Sky News.
Nice one. And Afterpay, before we let you go, reported a loss of $159 million, a bit bigger than expected.
About double what was expected by the market. Afterpay shares, though, are continuing to rise. They're at about $135 a share, and that's really all about the potential that this company has. So in the financial year, its sales did increase by almost 100% to $21 billion. Customers were up as well, but it did report a big loss of $159 million and did not declare a dividend. But really, the growth story for Afterpay is its United States business, where customers there grew by almost 90% during the year. And, of course, it is doing this deal with Square, which is owned by Twitter, founded by Twitter founder Jack Dorsey. That's going to go ahead in the next year, and that's a $39 billion deal.
Okay, sounds still pretty good to me. Ed, thanks so much. We'll see you soon.